Welcome, game developers! Are you looking to seamlessly integrate a user-friendly minimap into your project? This plugin is the perfect solution for you. First things first, we need to create a top-down representation of your level. Drag and drop a camera actor into your level. In the Details panel, set its location to the center of the map. 0, 0. Change the projection mode to orthographic for a flat 2D view. Rotate the camera actor's y-axis to minus 90 degrees. Adjust the orthographic width to encompass your entire level. This value will vary based on map size. Switch to the camera actor's view to capture the image. Open the console and type HiRaShot 5 to take a high-resolution screenshot, 5 being the resolution multiplier. Crop the screenshot to a square format using an image editing program like Photoshop. Create a new workspace with a resolution of 5000x5000 pixels. Import the screenshot and scale it to fill the entire workspace. Export the image and save it within your Unreal Engine project folder. Double-click the image asset in Unreal Engine. Locate the wrap settings and set both the X and Y axis tiling methods to clamp to prevent image stretching. In the World Settings panel, under Game Mode, set the HUD class to BP_minimap_HUD. Locate the Minimap plugin folder within your project. Tip: in settings, enable Show Engine Content to view engine plugin content. Navigate to Minimap System Content. Blueprints UI and Open UI _ display minimap. Select the Minimap Cord widget in the Details panel. Here you'll find various customization options. Player icon. Set the visual representation for the player on the minimap. Map image. Select the cropped image you created earlier. Zoom. Adjust the magnification level of the minimap. Dimension. Define the overall size of your level based on its furthest extents. How to know the size of the level? Place a static mesh in the top right corner of your level to determine its size. By positioning the map there, we observe that the right boundary extends to approximately 25,000 units. Given that the origin point is at the center, 0, 0, we deduce that the total dimension spans 50,000 units along both the X and Y axes. Imagine this as a coordinate system with an X and Y axis. The eyes open world parameter is only relevant if your map's center isn't at 0, 0. Leave it untouched if this applies. Rotate. Choose whether the minimap should rotate in sync with the player's character. Round. Select between a square or circular minimap shape. Let's put our minimap system to the test. Here we are in first person view. The minimap is conveniently located in the top left corner, but you can easily reposition it to your preference. Press the left alt key to place a hit marker on the minimap, indicating your point of interest. Now let's switch to third-person perspective and observe the minimap. If you haven't already imported a third-person character asset, simply do so and update the Game Mode setting in the World Settings panel. To open the larger map view, press the M key. Notice how the minimap updates dynamically as you move around the environment. While we've been adjusting parameters directly within the UI assets, there's an alternative method using blueprint functions. Open the level blueprint and navigate to the Begin Play event. Here we'll call the GetPlayerController function, followed by GetHUD, and casting it to the BP underscore MinimapHUD class. This allows us to access the set minimap and map image function. Simply provide the desired minimap and map images, though only the minimap image is mandatory. Set the dimensions to 50,000 as we determined earlier, and adjust the zoom factor to 0.3 for a more zoomed in view. It's crucial to incorporate a delay function to ensure the minimap system is fully initialized before applying these changes. Compile, save, and launch the game. You'll see the updated minimap and map images reflected. Optional. You can even add custom pins to the map, which can be configured in the UI underscore showmap asset. Thank you. Now let's delve into modifying some key parameters. Minimap style, zoom factor, and rotation. With these options at your disposal, you can tailor the minimap to perfectly complement your game's aesthetics and functionality. Now that we have a solid foundation, let's enrich the minimap with points of interest. Create a new actor and name it BP_actor_on_map. Open this blueprint for further configuration. Place a static mesh within the blueprint, referencing an appropriate mesh from your project's assets. Next, add a point of interest component to enable interaction with the minimap. In the Details panel, you can define whether this point of interest is static or dynamic. Assign an image icon to represent this point of interest on the minimap by selecting it from your asset library. Place the BP_actor_on_map within your level environment. Run the game to observe the newly added point of interest reflected in both the minimap and the larger map view. Let's take things a step further by incorporating a distance display widget into our actor. Add a BP_distance component to the actor blueprint. In the Details panel, set the widget class parameter to UI_distance. You can also choose to display an icon alongside the distance information. Play the game to witness the updated actor with the distance information displayed. Feel free to customize the icon image to match your preferences. Remember, you can further adjust the positioning of the BP_distance component as needed. In this section, we'll ensure the minimap and map remain up to date whenever actors are destroyed. First, add a box collision component to our actor and scale it to encompass the actor's size for accurate detection. Within the event graph, let's create a trigger using onComponentBeginOverlap. Within this trigger, obtain the player character and utilize a branch node to verify if the other actor colliding with our actor is indeed the player character. If the condition is met, we'll call the destroy actor function to remove the actor. Next, we'll retrieve the player controller and HUD, casting the HUD to the BP underscore minimap HUD class. Finally, we'll invoke the refreshMap function within the minimap HUD to ensure the minimap reflects the change. Run the level to witness this functionality in action. Now let's introduce a captivating feature, parameterizing the spawning of actors based on map pins. In essence, this allows actors to be spawned at specific locations designated by map pins. Open the UI underscore showmap asset and select the map chord widget element. Within the details panel's param section, locate the option for spawn actor class. This is where you'll specify the actor class you want to spawn when a pin is placed on the map. Choose the actor we created earlier. Play the game and open the larger map view by pressing M. Click on the map to create a pin. You can zoom in on specific areas of the map using your mouse scroll wheel. Observe how the spawned actor appears at the precise pin location. For added convenience, you can enable the placement of multiple pins on the map. Congratulations! You've constructed a robust and dynamic minimap system. In the next video, we'll embark on setting up multiplayer functionality and integrating navigation within the map. This will further enhance the player experience in your game.